నమస్కారం. శోభిల్లు సప్తస్వర కార్యక్రమానికి స్వాగతం. ఐఎమ్ హ్యాపీ టు పార్టిసిపేట్ ఇన్ దిస్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ విచ్ ఇస్ వెరీ ఇన్ఫర్మేటివ్ అండ్ గివ్స్ డీటెయిల్స్ అబౌట్ అవర్ ఇండియన్ క్లాసికల్ మ్యూజిక్. ఇన్ దిస్ ఎపిసోడ్ ఐడ్ లైక్ టు స్పీక్ టు యూ అబౌట్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద రాగాస్ విచ్ హెవ్ కమ్ టు సౌత్ ఇండియన్ క్లాసికల్ మ్యూజిక్ ఫ్రమ్ ద నార్త్, స్పెసిఫికలీ వన్ రాగా. Many countries in the world do not have the privilege of saying that they have a classical tradition, while in India we have not one but two classical traditions, the South Indian being Carnatic music and the North Indian being Hindustani music. Even now, in the beginning of the 21st century, the differences between the two systems are more prevalent than the similarities, mainly because of the very close-minded attitude of the musicians of both systems. But there have always been great souls in both systems who were curious about the other system. And now, at the end of the 20th century, jugalbandis have become a popular phenomenon. We find artists from both systems take a common raga like Mohanam or Bhopali, or Hindolam, Malkomas, Kalyani, Yaman, and try to have a friendly conversation, which more often than not ends up becoming a kind of competition. While some ragas themselves have gone from South Indian classical music to the North, like Hamsudhwani, the Hindustani people they call it Hansudhwani, Kirwani, Charukesi, Vachaspati, like that, many South Indian ragas have gone to North Indian classical music during the past 40 to 50 years. While much earlier than that, some Hindustani ragas have come down to South Indian classical music, like Kapi, what we call Kapi, Behag, Sindhu Bhairavi, Yaman Kalyan, ragas like that. In Carnatic music, we have many ragas like Bhairavi, which is one of our major ragas, which use two values for the same note. Like the Dhaivatam in Bhairavi, we have Pada, which is the big Dhaivatam, Pada Ni Sa Ni Da Pa. So da is there, da is also there. Like that, we have many ragas where the same note takes different values. But in Hindustani music, we have a whole range of extremely beautiful ragas where the madhyamam takes two different values, the Shuddha Madhyamam and Prati Madhyamam. We don't have, originally Carnatic music somehow missed out on that. We have Saranga perhaps and a few other ragas where the Ma takes two values. While in Hindustani music, we have Behag, we have Shuddha Sarang, we have Lalit, we have Yaman Kalyan, we have Purvi, so many ragas, and each one is very, very, very beautiful. And the specific reason for their beauty is how the Madhyamam is. Of course, Kedar is there, which we call Hamir Kalyani. So today, I'd like to give you some glimpses into the various facets of the very beautiful raga Behag, which has become a part of the Carnatic family. To the best of my knowledge, the first person to have brought down Behag to the south from Hindustani music was Maharaja Swaji Tirunal of Travancore, who has composed kirtanams, padams and javalis and Hindustani compositions in Behag. And if you look at the entire collection of compositions left by Maharaja, we find that, so if we look at Tyagaraja for example, there are so many compositions by him in Todi, in Chakraparnam itself. But Maharaja, though he composed songs in major Carnatic ragas like Todi and Bhairavi and Chakraparnam, we find that the maximum number of compositions composed by him is surprisingly in Behag. Behag, in its, I'm not a Hindustani musician, so I don't want to go too much into the pure Hindustani Behag. While some differences between how Behag is sung in North India and South India, I can show you now. In Hindustani music, the ga and ni are very, very important in Behag, and ri and dha are much, much less important. So even when we sing ga ri sa, we just touch the ri and we kind of slide over the ri to ga sa. I'll show you. Ga sa, ga ri sa. That we never do. In Carnatic music, we do that. Same with ni dha pa. Sa ni pa. Ni dha pa. We don't do that in Hindustani music. So I'll give you a few phrases, typical phrases of how Behag is in its original form, which is Hindustani. Ni like this. It's a very, very flowing and melodious raga. And the two ma's, the ma, which is the second ma, ma, the first ma, how beautifully we have various combinations of the two madhyamams. I'll show you. Pa ga ma ga, ma pa ga ma ga, pa ma ga ma ga, pa ma ma ga. Like that we have very beautiful combinations. While in Carnatic music, the traditional people, on the one hand, they criticize musicians when they bring in a phrase of Yaman while singing Kalyani. They say it's a pollution, you can't sing Yaman phrases in Kalyani. But the same people who say that, they pollute a Hindustani raga like Behag or Dwijavanti. Dwijavanti, it is called, the original raga is Jai Jayavanti. Jai Jai, two jas, Dwijavanti, that is the Carnatic name. So they will sing Behag Arohanam. In the system of Arohanam, Avarohanam itself is very Carnatic. In Hindustani, there are many ragas where we can't really define this is the Arohanam and this is the Avarohanam. The character of the raga is brought out because of characteristic chalan, chal, phrases, they say. So they say Behag Arohanam, Avarohanam is Sa ga ma pa ni da sa, sa ni da pa ma ga ma ga re sa. And they call it a janyam of Shankarabharanam. While actually it has nothing to do with Shankarabharanam. So the sa ni da pa ma ga ma ga re sa. Both the dha and re, which are very unimportant, are stressed. And sa ga ma pa, with the second madhyamam, we can sing Amritavashni like this. Sa ga ma pa ni sa ni pa ma ga sa ga ma pa. While in Behag it is sa ga ma pa ma ga ma. The nature of the ragam itself is much softer than these hard ragas. When we sing Athana, for example, we can't sing Athana softly. The nature of the raga itself is hard. While Behag is soft. And going up, we use the small madhyamam. Coming down, we use either small or both madhyamams together. Sa ga ma pa ma ga ma ga. But it doesn't mean that we have to sing Behag only in a very, very crooning, easy listening kind of way. We can sing raga lapana, tanam, swaram, pallavi, everything in Behag. Pa 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 ma pa ma pa pa ma pa pa ma pa ma pa pa ma pa pa ga ma ga. Sa pa ma pa ga ma ga ri za ni za ga ma pa ma pa ma pa ga ma ga ri za ni za ma ga ri za ni sa pa ma pa ma da ga ma ga ga ma pa ni 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 za ni za ni da pa ma da ga ma ga ri za ni za pa pa za ni za ma ga ri za ni za ga pa ma ri ma ga ri za ni za ga pa za ni da pa ga ma pa ni 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 za ni za ni za ni za ni da ba ma pa za ni da ba ma pa ma da ga ma ga ri za ni za ga ma pa ni 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 ri za ni da ba ma ga pa ma ga ri za ni ma da ba ma ga pa za ni da ba ga ma pa ni 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 za ni za ni za pa sa ni ga ma pa ni ni za ni za ni za 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 za. Like that we can sing swarams, but we have some foreign notes which have come in Carnatic music which are not there in Hindustani music, like the small nishadam, which is not there at all in Hindustani music. I'll show you. Pa ma pa ga ma da 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 ga ma da da ni pa da pa. This in Hindustani music they would say ga ma da da na 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 na. All these are phrases from a raga like khamaz, for example, but they have become part of Carnatic music. So it is better if we sing Behag the way we sing it in Carnatic music in a concert. It is better to announce it as South Indian Behag, because if we call it Behag and we sing these other phrases, the Hindustani man will laugh at us thinking he is singing Behag wrongly. Same, we have very beautiful phrases where Ri is very important. Na 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 na. Re, so Re comes prominently. Ma ba ma ba ma ba. Re ga ga ma ma da ma ga ni sa ga pa ma re ma ga re ni. All these are Carnatic phrases. One of the most popular compositions, Kirtanams in Behag, is composed by Maharaja Swaji Tirunal himself. So many others have composed Padams, Javalis, Bhajans, Tukadas, but this is a proper Kirtanam itself, that is Smarajanaka Shubhacharita Akhila Lokanayaka Mamava Taruna Sarasa Dalanayana Tapaniya Ruchi Vasana Dhara Tanu Vinindita Nirada Trita Narada Nata Bhurita. So people add Narada Nata Bhurita Narada Nata Bhurita Smarajanaka Shubhacharita Paripalita Bhuvana Samudaya Parama Purusha Hare Bhala Shobhita Surabhi Mruga Mada Bhala Shobhita Surabhi Mruga Mada Bhala Shobhita Surabhi Mruga Mada Padmanabha Jaganuta Smarajanaka Shubhacharita. This is from Maharaja. He himself has composed a very popular Telugu Javali. Saramaina Matalanto Chalu Chalu Rasami. This is from a Maharaja who lived in Kerala 200 years ago. I'm so curious and interested in other cultures, other forms of music, other languages also. Then Annamacharya, though he was a composer who lived much before the Trinity, Tyagaraja, Dikshitar, Swatirnal, Shyama Shastri, his compositions were discovered only in the 20th century, most of them. And one of the first Annamacharya compositions to be tuned was were tuned by my Guruji, Dr. Balamurli Krishna. And many people don't know the fact that very popular songs like Brahma Katikina Padamu in Mukhari or Narayanate Namonamo in Behag were actually tuned by him in 1940s. Narayanate Namonamo goes like this. Narayanate Namo Namo Bhavad Naradasal Nutanamo Namo. So Naradasal, this is a very typical Carnatic phrase. Gari Pamagari Sani Nara, that is also a Carnatic phrase. Then the Charanam has a very typical Daivatam and small Nishadam usage. Murahar Nagathara Mukunda Madhava. Murahar Nagathara Mukunda Madhava. Garuda Gamana Pankajanabha. Gamadadadanidanipadapa. That is this Kamaz like phrase. Murahar Nagathara Mukunda Madhava. Garuda Gamana Pankajanabha. Paramapurusha Bhava Bhanjanate Namo. Paramapurusha. Again, Bhava Bhandanisa, which is again totally Karnataka. In Hindustani, we will never have Padanisa, we will never have Gama Panisa Neba Maga. So, Paramapurusha Bhava Bhanjanate. It will become like that if it's sung in a Hindustani way. Paramapurusha Bhava Bhanjanate, again a Carnatic phrase. Namo Naramraga Sharira Namo Namo. O Narayana Te Namo Namo. Behag is very, very popularly used in devotional songs, in light music, in film songs also. From the birth of Hindi film songs, when talkies came and Kundan Lal Saigal, K.L. Saigal was the ruling king all over, not only India, but India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Afghanistan, Fiji, Sri Lanka, all these countries were dominated by one single voice. So he used to sing many, many songs in Behag.
E dilet bekarar jhoom, e dilet bekarar jhoom,
that is like that. Then Lata Mangeshkar has sung,
Hamare dil se na jana, dhoka na kana, duniya bade beiman, hamar,
like that. Then Bhadrachal Ramadas songs are tuned by various people. I recently heard,
Hari Hari Rama Nama Nannara Mara Judaku, Nirata Muni Nama Smaranaye Maraju.
Like that I heard in Behag. Same song is sung in different tunes by other composers also. So these are some of the points I would like to share with you about the Raga Behag. Thank you.